What up, peeps, and welcome to another Let's Play with your boy, Mr. Trans. This time around, we're going to be playing some Valheim. We're going to start the game off by making ourselves a new character. Done. Hey, what in the hell? That big ass bird. Hey man, where are you taking me, bro? Hey. Huh? Why are you so shiny? Like a metallic bird or something. I think it's supposed to look like it's wet. The whole thing just looks metallic. Whatever. No big deal. Oh, don't land in the trees, dick! Ah, come on. Oh, you just gonna fucking drop me down like that, bro? I could have broke my legs, man. He brings tidings. And it guides you to mark your travels. All right, now that we're done talking to the little bird, you can see on the map, we actually have some of our friends in here with us. We got our buddy John's playing. Our buddy Gunny is playing today as well. That's a deer. So, it's just kind of time for us to go out, farm some wood and stuff, and get started. Find where we're going to live. That's probably the key thing right now. Ooh, look, we got berry bushes. Got berry bushes and trees and stuff. Okay. Let's see if we can't find another. Oh, there's one of those creatures. Net creature. I kind of want to go across over here. Kind of think I'm gonna do. Oh, my buddy John went over there too. All right, so I found this little house right here, and I went in there, got some more coins out of that bad baby. Now just trying to steal. I think we're all just scouting at the moment, trying to figure out where it is we want to build. What you want, bird? Huggins with a tool. I just made a hammer, so he's telling me that I can use the hammer to craft stuff. This is actually how you build in this game. Must have hammer in hand. Okay, we made it across. We're pretty far from everyone else, but that's okay. We're going to find a spot, I tell you. Oh, what is this? Found us in place of one of the Forsaken. Okay. So we found one of the Forsaken spots. There we go. And you got them more, baby. Man, chopping this log, it almost fell on top of me. Totally forgot. In this game, when logs fall, they will crush you if you're underneath them. So. Oh, look at this. Look what we found. Whole bunch of little huts and everything already freaking ready. Man, I might tell Jonathan about this spot. We were trying to find a spot for all of us to build. This place already got some fences up. We got houses already built halfway. All right, so I put down a fire. We got ourselves something to cook it on. Then we got Huggins is back again. But, yeah, I think this is where we're coming. I think John and Gunny on their way over here, so I went ahead and put down a crafting table. You can see a whole bunch of new recipes and stuff are popping up. It's kind of like most other survival games where once you grab a resource, it'll then tell you, oh, well, now that you picked up wood, you know how to use wood to craft stuff. So that's kind of what you see happening right now. What does Huggins want? Let's go. So now I need to repair. I think I'm going to take this house. Bam, baby. What up, Huggins? Oh, snap. What the hell you want again, Huggins? You have crafted a hoe. So you can see right here, guys, we're going to give you a little update. This right here is John's place. That's mine. I'm still with a little basic bitch house. But I'm over here putting in the palisade walls while they work on their bases or their houses so that we make sure that we do not get raided. Because one of the features in this game is after a while, I don't know what actually sets it off, but the god of the area or whatever will send creatures to come raid your base and stuff. And so the one time that I did it, it wasn't that difficult, but I'm assuming it gets more difficult as we go along and play. So I got most of the palisade wall put up over here. I'm working on the wall defenses while Gunny's working on his base or his hut. John's over here working on his. I'm just going to stick with this one because this is just our first little outpost. But I'm going to work on defenses since they want to do that. But I was over here and I thought I saw something. Where'd it go? There's something over here. That was pretty neat. Right here. Like a little abandoned shack out here. Like farmhouse. I was like, man, this is pretty cool. There's like, this is like abandoned building stuff. Ooh, there's a chest. Yes, give me that. Can I take that? Yeah, give me that. I can't take all that stuff. Anything else over here? We're not going to go too far. We don't worry about the defense right now. But yeah, I just wanted to kind of see what this was with you guys. Yeah, cool little barn. So one of the neat things in this game is that you have to maintain your hunger like any other survival game, but you have to maintain it from three different food sources, it looks like. Right, each one has different, food value or whatever, of course. On the bottom left, you can see there's three little squares, and each one of those fills with different foods. So, like, right now, my raspberries aren't blinking, meaning they're still good, so I can't eat anymore. It says you can't eat more. But as soon as that starts blinking, I can eat another one. So you can only eat three different things at a time, which I thought was pretty neat. So let me get back to putting this wall up real quick, because I want to make sure we don't get freaking sieged. Well, I may or may not have just died. Like I said earlier, trees will fucking kill you. They will kill you. Yes. What's up, man? Over the mortar bow, small part of my abilities, and drop my belongings. I don't know what that means. You forget a small part of your build. That's crazy. Like, what does that mean? I did have a bed down, so I'm lucky there. And luckily, just before I came out of the freaking farm, I actually hit E on it to claim it because I forgot when you put a bed down, you have to actually claim it, and if I wouldn't have done that, I would have spawned all the way at the beginning. But anyways, yep, still over here, just farming fucking wood. Alright, so now we got the wall all the way up to the wall, from one water to the other water. Everybody's over here working on the bases, got some gates up. I put some ladders up here, so when we do get sieged, we can defend ourselves, hopefully. Yeah, and now I'm just kind of working on some other things while we wait for that to happen. And I think we're all trying to start finding our way to the boss and try to figure out where he's at so we could move on to the next area. I think my next goal is probably going to be to go over that way. I think we'll create a raft and go over there. But we also have, I want to show you guys, we also have another person playing now. We have another one of my buddy John's friends named Woody. He's also joined us, and we have two more people playing. So yeah, you'll see a couple other people just running around getting their Viking on. Everybody's building a base except for me, huh? I'm just kind of sticking with this. All right, anyways, let's get back to work. Time to farm a little bit more wood. So apparently in this game, when you hit one tree, if it has enough momentum and smashes into another tree, this one tree took down these two, that one, which took out that one, which then took out that one. And all these trees I got to cut just from cutting down one. That's pretty sick. So the next little bit that you're going to see is going to be me running around with my buddies. We're going to run around and go fight the boss. I'm just going to do like a quick little speed run through that. Yeah. Hopefully we succeed.
Oh, it's day 5 already. So
Jesus Christ.
Job done.
He says he can't sleep at this time.
Yeah, because it's daylight. Oh. Or going to be daylight here in a second.
Oh, it's morning, not evening. Okay.
Yeah, we're going to need a deer's head anyway.
Thanks.
Oh, I got one of those. Two of those.
I didn't want to come out anyway.
Just one?
Yeah, one will do it.
Okay.
Oh, what the fuck?
All right, we need to be heading northeast. Okay. That away.
I found another Forsaken one. Does it have to be a different one? Because I found one that's right up here to the right of us.
Yeah, there's one near the base.
Yeah, it's right up here. Is that the one we're going to?
I think so.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, that's right. Because you said northeast and I went northwest. So my bad. It's right over here. I have it marked on the map.
Can you put markers down on the map?
Yeah. When you on the bottom right, you see the little thing. You just click whatever image and then double click on the map. And you can name it. Should be like right here. I was hoping you guys would be able to see it too, since we're all playing with each other, but I guess not.
What do we have to offer it then?
See what actually. So what happened was it like
a deer head?
We only need a person, so we're gonna need you to like lay down on the table.
Right.
We didn't want to tell you that.
Yeah, I'm gonna drop this on the ground for you, Gunny.
I think you do it right. There should be a hook or something around here somewhere, right?
Oh, we need one more.
Oh shit.
What, one more trophy?
Yeah, or deer head.
Oh, damn it. Alright, I'll be back. I got three of them.
That's not the way to the base, is it?
Wait, no, it's not. Setting off in the sunset the wrong way.
Right. I'll be back. Goes on an adventure.
Y'all be like, hey, man, coming back? Oh, shit, dude, I totally forgot.
Right. I smoked the J.
Yeah.
Totally forgot.
It was this thing that was shiny. And...
Notice the deer sound like monkeys?
Yeah, it took me a while to figure out what the hell that noise was.
I said, man, there's a lot of monkeys in this fucking area.
Oh, you gotta be kidding. I only have boar heads. I don't have any.
Well, go in my. There. Can you access my chest in my house? There's a deer head in there.
Yep. I got it.
I should have just brought them both.
I do the same shit, man. Like, it makes a difference if I bring all of them or just one. You always end up bringing too little. Like, damn.
Two altars next to each other.
All right. Somebody's beating up pigs.
There you go, Gunny.
Yeah.
Right next to you.
All right, gents. Where you at, John?
I'm at the altar.
The other one.
What, is that a different altar over there?
Yep.
What the fuck? Ow.
That's procedural generation.
Okay, give me a sec. Oh, I'm out of stamina. Oh, just jumped right over it. Fuck it. Never mind. Let's go.
I think my dude jumps like he's doing the fucking hurdles. Okay, let's go.
Toasty. Shit,
what's about to happen? What?
If you get an arrow in the back, I'm sorry.
Oop. Oh, there's up. Oh. My stamina.
Whoa, flying donkey.
Oh,
I shot him in the pee-pee.
Bro, it looks like he has like Christmas lights on his antlers. Oh shit. Oh. Hurt.
We've got abs.
Fucking stamina.
Boy, hurdle jump. Did we all get that, the trophy and stuff?
Nope.
No. Who picked up the trophy?
I got it. Then the antlers. Did anybody else get that?
All right. No. Now we need to go. Oh shit! That's quite a fucking way. We need to go back up to the circle.
I'll hang the thing up on there. I'll go up there. Or does it activate something?
I think we all better go.
Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna see what the hell this little bird wants. He won't hug us. Oh yeah, it says to return the stones, offer a sacrifice to make the gods smile upon you. Okay.
Yeah, we gotta go and hang it on the hook.
Yeah.
Where we spawned.
Hell yeah.
How many pieces of hard horn did we get?
Three. Of antler horns, three.
Yeah, I think we're gonna need one each. So we'll probably have to do that again.
Okay. I was kind of curious how that was going to work because technically none of us are in like a party or group or tribe or anything. We're just all playing together. Where'd y'all go? Let's see.
Get that swim level up, boys.
It's got like the big blue shield.
I actually slid down this hill earlier.
That's north. Run, Moose, run. Ow.
I'm right here. So it said press E to attach item. Everybody here yet?
No.
I'm waiting. All right, we're all good now, right? All right.
No. Right, hang that sucker up, see if we all get it.
Yeah. attach item. Your ability to run and jump is improved. Jump stamina is negative 60%. Run stamina is negative 60%. And I can activate power. Right, can you guys interact with it?
Next yeah. target, power using times of need, blah, blah, blah.
Oh, so you guys don't see the truck? It's hanging up. Y'all don't see it?
Yeah, I see it. I see it. Oh,
yeah.
You just
got one. Yeah, cool, cool. All right. I'm about to say, man, we got to do this for everybody every time.
Right? Like, I'll go back to single player.
Yeah.
Everybody activated it?
I did.
I have, yep.
Yeah.
So,
but we're going to have to do it again anyway, because I think it's one of those hardened horns per pick.
Okay, that's fine. I don't know if we want to hunt down some deer real quick and get some and get it done real quick.
So we're going to need another couple of deer heads.
All right, folks. So that was fun. I actually really enjoyed that boss. Enjoying the mechanics. Kind of sucks that not everybody gets the drops from the boss, but it is cool that at least everybody gets to access this. And I guess it doesn't really matter because I can drop these to people, but this right here is what we really need. We need to go get more of these. So I think we're going to fight the boss a couple times to farm some of those. But that's going to be it for today. I'm really digging this game, so I think we're going to continue to play it. I think we'll do a review later down the road. But remember, if you enjoyed the content, leave a comment, hit the like, smash that subscribe. All that support is greatly appreciated. And I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.